Right, Hel, we're all hitched. We're off the pitch.
Yeah, we're sorted.
And we're now leaving
Ferry Meadows,
that's right. Yeah. We're leaving Ferry Meadows. You have to think when you go to so many places, aren't you, where you are, where you're going to. That's my sat nav telling me I'm going in the wrong direction, but I'm not even left the site yet. So we're off, we're going up the A1 for a little while. We've got about an hour's drive.
Yeah.
And we're off to where?
We're off to
Aikettleby Lakes. Yeah. One that you've recommended for us. We're looking forward to it. We've seen a few of the other YouTubers that have been there, notably Rob's Wise Ways, Rob and Gail. And what we have noticed is, and it's a pure fluke this, Rob, we're staying on the same
on
pitch,
your pitch
that you were on last time, pitch 26.
Looks quite nice, actually. It's quite big.
It's one of them big pitches, isn't it?
Yeah.
So as we leave here, we'll put the camera out front for you. It's a little bit grey, but it is warm, very warm. I've got a bit of a sweat on.
16, the car says.
Yeah, it feels more than that because I've been busting my butt. That's why.
That's good.
Yeah, right. We'll show you a little bit of the journey in, won't take long. And we'll see you.
When we get there.
Yeah, we're staying on the site, but the barrier's not opening for us.
Oh, okay. No problem. I'll leave the barrier for you.
Thank you. Got a new friend here. Hello. Who are you? So shop and reception is just over here. So check in nice and easy. And just across the road from the shop is the tea room and the bar. Once you've checked in, though, you drive down to your pitch, and depending on what site you're on, because there's two sites, there's a southern site and the northern site. We're on the northern site, which you can see from on the map here. Just drive down straight onto your pitch, and the job's a good one. There we are, pitch 26. So I'll just quickly show you around the pitch, starting this side. Got a 10 meter electric hookup cable is sufficient. I really like the fact that the waste drain is there. And look, it's below the height of the caravan, because it would be just there, wouldn't it? But one collapsed pipe and straight in the center, which is brilliant. Car at the side, I think Rob and Gail, when they were on this pitch, I think Rob said just could have done with a bit more of a wider bit on this side. So probably just, if they lost the grass bit here, then you got a bit more room for the car, because I'm right on the edge. But anyway, never mind. You've then got a little square bit here to put your awning or your sun canopy on, which is what we've got. And we've got our lighting in. A lot of blossom falling off the trees, Helen. Looks like we've had a wedding in here.
Hello.
But it's good, it's great. And then you've got your own private sort of lawned area here where you can sit out in the sunshine, have a picnic, whatever. But it's nice and private. So we're very happy with that. Then we're going to head straight down there to the tea room and see if we can get something to eat. So if you fancy a game of darts, in there, nice and safe, not going to injure anybody. And they've got a few games in here as well, look. So that's quite good. I might take that, and Helen and I can have a game of this now. This will keep her occupied. Long bar down there. And then on the other side is the non-dog seating area. Big widescreen TVs everywhere. If you want to play pool, you can do. And then this lovely seating area here is if you've got your dog with you, and you can sit in here. Nice big windows overlooking the lit lake at the back. Open fire for the cooler months. Log burner, yeah. This is a game I'm going to take you on, and the winner doesn't have to do anything for the rest of the holiday.
Well,
and what you've got to do, Helen, is you've got to hook your ring, right? Each throw, right? You've got to hook your ring. So I'll try and get the ring on that hook. Not like that, Dave. I've never done this before, obviously. No. Oh.
No.
Oh, I nearly had it there. First one to hook is the winner. Oh! Crikey. How long is this video going to be?
I've done it.
No way. That was a fluke. Best of three, obviously.
No, it's not.
No, it is. Always best of three.
I've got the rest of the holiday off.
Cheers. You've had the holiday off so far. What are you talking about? Look at her. You love it, don't you?
Yes.
Where's Bella at this moment in time?
It's under the chair.
There she is. The little doggy.
Hello,
you're a bit too close there. Oh, yeah, a bit too close. There's food coming. You'll be happy in a minute. So I've gone for the hot roast beef sandwich here. A bit of side salad and crisps.
Topped up with a bowl of chips. And Helen, what have you got?
Cheese and red onion panini.
Good.
And you're drinking cider, are you?
No, no, it's just soda water.
Soda and black for Helen and a nice cup of tea for me. Enjoy. Nice outdoor seating area here, but look at these. There's a dog fight going on. Oh, look at that one, he's big. I think they come looking for food, you know. Well, that's our pitch, 26, just over the hedge. Let's say, Helen, everywhere is very clean and extremely immaculate. I mean, look, this is a
pitch. It's good, isn't it?
Yeah, and we've got the extended pitch, haven't we?
Yeah.
But do like the privacy hedges all the way around. Grass is neat, nicely cut. Very good. All very good. But anyway, here's the entrance to the dog walk, and it's all nice wood bark chips to walk on. I think they're okay for the dog, must be.
Yeah, let's go.
Come on then, you take Muffet. She doesn't like being with me for some reason. She's clingy to Helen, very clingy. Now there's a, I'll show you a map of the place in a little while, but there's a number of walks around the actual site itself, around all the different lakes, and the walk into Melton Mowbray. Yeah. But it's a bit too far for us, that walk, isn't it, Helen?
Yeah, yeah.
So we'll be taking the car to Melton Mowbray, because
yeah.
I want a pork pie.
Ah.
You can't come to Melton Mowbray and not have a pork pie. You're not going to have one?
No, I don't like it.
Oh, that's a shame. That means I get the whole pork pie to myself. You'll start singing that song again, won't you?
Who ate all the pies?
Who ate all the pies? She thinks it's funny. Right, just going to show you the toilets and the showers. Two different types. There's some units that are completely self-contained, and then there are separate gents' toilets, and I'm sure separate ladies as well. But see if we can get in here. Right, there's pipe music in the toilets, so I've had to do a voiceover here. Let me tell you, immaculately clean and really warm. It's underfloor heating, and the heat just radiates through the shower cubicle as well. Even through the toilet itself. So, superb. A wash hand basin, you've got hair dryers in here as well. And you've also got a nice little bench to sort of sit on while you're getting yourself changed, put some clothes on out of the way of the shower. Absolutely perfect, immaculate. What more do you want? Beautiful morning here at iKettleby. We thought we'd pop out for a bit of sort of mid-morning breakfast, really, didn't
well,
we?
You did.
Where are we going?
All we seem to do is eat.
Well, everyone has to eat. You die if you don't eat.
Yeah, but...
Where are we going to go?
We're going to go to the local farm shop, just 2 miles up the road here, I think.
I don't think it's even that far, but it's 2 minutes, that's for sure. So we're going to show you. Sun on the caravan, great pitch this, absolutely loving it. Let's go. Because over there in the distance you can make out the caravans on the south side, can't you? So that's how far we are away. There's the site. And here's the farm shop. March House Farm Shop. Let's go and have a little look. So we've got a machine over here that makes a fresh orange. I'll just show you because it is really good. Like you see in Spain. There's a machine, look, they can make you one up.
Okay.
Have a bit of kit. We bought a bottle yesterday, it was fantastic.
I think about 16 to 18 oranges in there.
Is it really? That
yeah.
Quick, isn't it?
Yeah.
Brilliant. There it is. Right. The full March House.
myself.
Thought I would.
Yeah, I thought you would.
Did you see the beef in that fridge at the front?
Okay.
I'll try and get a picture of that.
Good job, it's your birthday.
Oh, yeah.
That, ladies and gentlemen, is a birthday breakfast. I wouldn't normally indulge in such a big one as this.
Nah.
I normally just go with the one sausage.
What you got, Hal?
Well, I wanted scrambled egg, but they did have it.
Thank you.
Believe it or not, they just had poached. I don't like it. So I just went for some pancakes and bacon.
That is a John Candy breakfast, that is.
Probably is. Can I have a bit of your sausage just to try it?
Oh.
That's what you call a joint, ribs of beef. Look at these. Wow, very good.
Well, I thought I would just come over and say hello to the moo cows, because there's some babies here, look. Hello. Look at these. Look at you. Look at you then. Hello. Come and say hello. You're going to come and say hello? Some big cows here, look. That was me making the noise, not the cows. Hello. Hello then. You're a big cow. Actually, you're very big. You're not a bull, are you? Might be. No, you're a cow, are you? You got a lot of flies on you, mate. Haven't you? You got a lot of flies on you. A lot of flies. They're big. Big cattle. Big cattle having a drink. See you later then, guys. You're not very old, are you? Hey? See you later. Well, Ikettleby Lakes is owned by the Lomas family, and primarily they're farmers from what I can gather, but I'm pretty impressed with some of their farming techniques, including that. That's good to see. Plenty of solar there doing their bit for the site and for green energy. And then over here in their field, big wind turbine working hard as well, and it's got a little bit of a breeze today to make it work even better. You won't pick it up on the camera, but there's a hawk hovering. He's just gone down. I don't think they'll get it on the camera. Right, here we go then. We're dog walking. If Helen can get through the gate, we'll be well away.
I can get through the gate, but they have got hand sanitizer, which is really good.
Yeah, I've noticed those around the site.
So many times I've tried at different places, I've tried to get some, and there's none in it.
And they're empty, aren't they? Yeah, I noticed I took some rubbish to the bins and there were sanitizers by the rubbish bins as well. So that's really good. Right, go on the hell, give that
great
give
pleasure
that gate a push.
To get her off the lead. She's a
pest. She's a bit of a pest these days. What's going on with you, Bella? She suddenly decided she didn't like the caravan as much as she used to. When we first got her, she loved being in the caravan, but to be honest with you, I think she just loved her freedom because she was a caged dog, which was terrible. And then we got her and she loved the caravan at first, but these days she seems very weary of things.
It's
like
a toaster, because the smoke alarm went off.
Well, I've not used a toaster for a year.
Yeah, but she remembers.
But yeah, when the smoke alarm used to go off, you used to get a bit nervous of that. Come on, miss. She's eating grass now, look. Wait, Juju.
Bella.
And then she was also nervous, like when the water pump goes on and stuff like that. She hates any sort of bleeping sounds. So the nice thing about this walk is that we're on grass, the dog can come off the lead, and the pathways have been cut so you can get around nice and easy, see where you're walking. So we're at the top end of this particular part of the dog walk, but it is extended, so you can pop out of this gate here, and by the way, what I do like, lots of bins for your dog waste to go into, which is great, but then you can go through here and through that gate, and you can circumnavigate this field over here where the wind turbine is. I'm told, I've got it on good authority, that in the calf here, they do some good grub. So We'll go and find out. Actually, we went over last night thinking we might get a meal last night, but they don't do food in the evenings, do they?
Not on the Wednesday, no.
Well, they do any night. What they do, they have food during the day, and then the tables are all set up. But what they have is a lot of takeaway menus, some local sort of takeaway, you know, Indian, Chinese, fish and chips, burgers, pizzas, that sort of thing, kebabs. So we had a look at some of those. We ordered a burger last night and some chips and chicken wings and stuff.
And they brought it to the caravan.
Brilliant, wasn't it?
Which was quite good, actually.
Yeah, yeah, they were quite busy. We had about an hour wait, but that's all right. And they delivered it straight to the caravan. Yeah. It wasn't Just Eat that delivered. It came straight from the restaurant. So lots of choice.
Yeah.
And they know the site well, because when I phoned to place the order, they just said, what caravan are you in? I said, we're in on caravan 26 on the north side. They said, yeah, we know where it is. And they brought it straight to the caravan. So we were pretty pleased with that, weren't we? And a really nice burger too.
It's true, we do a lot of eating in this video. In fact, we eat most days. It's true. So we went to get some fish and chips, or rather I did, drove up to the fish and chip stall that came. And whilst I was there, I was speaking to so many subscribers, it's absolutely unbelievable. Didn't get everyone's name, but if you were one of those that were chatting to me in the queue, it was great to see you and hear your little stories and tales about caravanning. But I should call out a few people that definitely did leave a message. And so starting off with Emma and Dean. Emma and Dean from Sutton Coldfield have got a fantastic Bailey Alicanto Grande. Managed to nick a photograph of it here, actually. And check out those chairs. Don't be surprised, you two, if you see those chairs in one of our future videos, because Helen's in love with those, really likes them. Also, hello to Andrew and Dawn from Warrington. They've got a lovely Swift Elegance, and we met them while we were out dog walking, so hi to you two. Also to Andrew, who was chatting to me in the fish and chip queue. Good to see you. And also to Ken and his good lady, whose name I didn't get, but they caught us walking past their caravan and dropped us a message. And also to Ivan and Angela, who we caught with at the garden centre, and they've been actually locally to us at Scrapby Hall. Also, hello to Jay, who was on the pitch next door to us. Good to meet you. Hope you had a safe trip back to Manningtree. And this is me just arriving at the fish and chip stall.
Food.
Oh, David, you bloody plonker.
Food.
What do you mean, you plonker?
The plonker's over there, look. Look at that plonker. She's gagging for a bit of your cod. Abzi, are you waiting for fish? Are you waiting for some of your mum's fish? Are you? Are you waiting for some of mum's fish?
I'll tell you something, the fish and chips from my kettle be lakes. The van pulls up outside. This is a cracking bit of fish, isn't it, Helm?
We've got on tomorrow on a diet.
Say that again without a mouthful of food? We're going home tomorrow and getting on a diet?
Yes, we are.
We've done nothing but eat since we got here.
It's fucking useless.
Hello, Helen.
Yeah.
What do you reckon to this place?
Very old.
Think he's got a ghost?
This is the Royal Oak at where?
I think it's a place called Great Dolby.
Okay.
It's only a few miles from Ikel, I
think. Yeah, about a 3-minute drive, isn't it? Something like that. So we've ordered up.
A
little look around the gaff. Go on, you're going to say?
We phoned and booked a table, but to be honest with you, it's a good sign because there's quite a few cars in the car park, and there isn't many tables left.
So no, it's pretty busy in here.
Looking at the menu, it's quite nice.
Well, I've gone as a starter. I've gone for the prawn and crab cocktail. You're not bothering with a starter, are you?
I'm not.
What are you having to eat then?
I'm going to have offer specials board, pan-fried salmon, greens and new potato.
Oh, very nice.
Well, I'm afraid because it's my birthday tomorrow.
Hey, Dave. Guess who this is? Go on, have another guess. No, it's not Tom Cruise. It's Chubbs. Got a lot in common, me and you. You like your caravans, a great yeah with it. Me too. We'll be there today. It's pierced. Because I was selling pigs. So it's your birthday. Well, you've got a good family, I'll tell you that. You've got three kids, all them grandchildren. So call your fucking Dave Walton. Any road, you have a lovely, lovely day. thinking about you. Save us a bit of cake. See you, Dave. Cheers.
I'm going to go for the 8-ounce sirloin. Served with flat cap mushrooms. I can't read it. Pub blush tomato, there we go. Salad and chunky chips. And I'm going to add the peppercorn sauce for £3.30. Wow. Anyway, quick look at the pub. Full of character. I like it. And through there, look. And I'll show you the rest when we go out and show you the outside. It's very, very old, isn't it?
Very old.
We're now going to have a ghostly tale from Helen. A ghostly tale from Helen.
Right, so we've heard a bit of information about the pub.
Right.
Is it the Royal Oak?
The Royal Oak, yeah.
Yeah. It was made in the 1500s, but this is a bit of an extension. There is a ghost, and it's a woman called Alice, and she's also got a ghost Alsatian, which died first. And when they sit in the bar and have a drink at the end of the night, they see shapes moving around at the corner of their eyes. So that's quite interesting, isn't it?
Mains have arrived. 8-ounce sirloin, medium with peppercorn sauce, chunky chips, side salad, and a big flat mushroom there for me. But look at Helen's. What's this, Helen?
Pan-fried salmon,
yep.
Green beans, ratatouille, and new potatoes.
My goodness.
Very nice.
Very nicely presented. Looking the business. And I'm on my second pint. Helen's driving tonight. Camden Town Brewery IPA. Fantastic. A candlelit dinner would not be complete without sweet. Helen, what we got?
It's creme brulee, and it looks like some kind of red fruit compote. I'm not sure what that is. A little bit cake.
Biscuit.
Cake.
Just smash that top bit. Is it solid? Oh, it is.
Yeah.
Solid as a rock.
Yeah.
Well done. Looks good. For me, check this out. This is chocolate orange tart with cream and looks like white chocolate on the side and a little strawberry.
Well, it really was an amazing stay at iKettleby Lakes, and a big thank you to everyone that recommended this 5-star site for us to stay at. And could I also say thank you to everyone that wished me a happy birthday. So many fantastic messages on the socials, on Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, and also, of course, here on YouTube. Thank you, everyone. Had a fantastic birthday. And don't forget, if you've been to somewhere pretty special that you think's top draw, let us know about it in the comments below, because we're always looking for different sites to go to, and we don't mind really where they are. We're prepared to travel, and if we can get along to them, we will do, and of course we'll make a video so we can share it with all of you as well. Now, like I always say, if you haven't done so yet, now's a good time to subscribe. Hit the subscribe button, give us a thumbs up, and hit the notification bell. That'll let you know when all the videos are being released. And do leave a comment. We love the comments. We answer every single comment that we get. And at the making of this video, we're just about on 10,000 subscribers. So a massive, massive thank you to each and every one of you that subscribe to the channel. Helen and I both really appreciate it very much. But we'll be back with you next week with another one. Until then, thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon. Bye for now.
Bye.